Next question is from Britt Cox Rich. I struggle to sleep more than 7 hours a night. Which part of sleep is best for recovery? And is it possible to increase just that part, such as deep sleep? If so, how?
Good question.
Yeah, so yeah, the deep sleep part supposedly is most important for recovery. But honestly, all of them are equally important because you don't necessarily just jump into one stage without going through the other stages. Can you make 7 hours of sleep better than 9 hours of sleep?
Sure you can.
Yeah, it depends, right?
You can accelerate getting into REM.
Well, you can, but what my point is that you need to have quality sleep. So 7 hours of good sleep is better than 9 hours of shitty sleep.
Of course. Yeah.
And the ways you do that are the same ways you do, you know, what we talked about before.
But isn't what constitutes, you know, 9 hours of bad sleep much of the time is people failing to get into REM, right?
Yeah.
And taking a long time to get there at all, or being interrupted while you're in REM,
yes,
right? Isn't
yes.
that normally what constitutes bad sleep is the interruption of that deep REM sleep, or how long it takes you to get into that REM sleep.
Yeah, and the ways you can help that are, you know, you have a sleep routine, turn off your electronics a couple hours before you go to bed, limit your caffeine intake. Definitely don't have caffeine after maybe 2 p.m. or 4 p.m. for people who are not super sensitive would be the latest, I would say. Sleep in a very cool room. Those are things that can help. You can also try using cannabinoids. Some people find that cannabinoids make a big difference. I know CBD has been shown in some studies to increase the recovery aspect of sleep for some people. So you could do like we work with a company called Ned. They make a sleep blend. That might help you out. But you really got to take your sleep seriously. You can't just, you know, you're on your computer watching TV and they're like, all right, time to go to bed, and just, you know, expect yourself to get in. To good sleep.
Well, random that. So I didn't know that. One, I didn't know you picked this question and see it ahead of time. Two, I didn't know that we had Chili as a commercial today. But I actually, when I was on the phone with Chili negotiating our 2021 contract, one of the things that we were talking about that's been great, because I always like to, you know, how's the company been doing and what all their side stuff. And one of the things that they said that's been great this year is because of all these tools like Aura Rings and Fitbits and everything that monitor sleep.
Oh, people can measure.
Yes. There's been a lot of people that have been tracking their quality of sleep improvement when they actually start using this tool. So, you know, here's
based on how many times they kind of wake up or like wrestle with their sleep.
Yeah. And then how quick they get into REM. Like you can see all that like with Aura Rings. I think
because you fidget a lot more, right, when you're not in REM.
So, and that's the thing that and that it's hard, right? So like you use tools like, you know, blue blockers to get you in sleep, or you use things like Ned Sleep or use ChiliPad, and people are like, it's so hard to like, is it working? Is it being better for me? I get up the same time. Like a lot of times we think that it's all about, you know, am I sleeping 8 hours, 9 hours or longer? But it's not. It's about how quick do you fall asleep, get into that REM sleep, and then how little is it interrupted through the night that normally is what constitutes really good sleep. And tools like this is what they help. Whether they're tools to help you get ready, like your routine, like Sal is saying, or that keep you at a temperature throughout the night, those things are valuable. And that's where if you're somebody who is trying to get better sleep, you know, if you get great sleep and then these things may be a waste of money for you. But if you're somebody who is trying to improve sleep, or you get up a lot through the night, or you toss and turn a lot, this is where I see a lot of value in things like this.
Yeah, the biggest issue for a lot of people without realizing is caffeine. It really is. And,
yeah.
And they don't, people don't want to face this because caffeine is quite,
'cause it works.
It's enjoyable, it's addicting, and if you have bad sleep, you need it the next day.
Right, it's a ritual.
And caffeine consumption has only increased in recent years, and it's funny, I'll work with clients and I'll tell them to reduce their caffeine intake, and there's a lot of hawing, and we go, you know, back and forth. Finally, they'll reduce it or eliminate it, and they'll all come back and be like, oh my God, best sleep ever. It's like, I didn't really think caffeine made that big of a difference. It makes a huge difference. You know, if you're having bad sleep and you have caffeine, even if it's one coffee, cut it and then watch what happens. Here's something interesting with the ChiliPad, Adam. There's a feature, I've talked about this before, I don't know if you guys have done this yet, where you can have it increase the temperature of your bed to help wake you up in the morning so you don't need an alarm clock. Have you guys tried this yet?
Yeah, I felt like I needed to pee right away.
Did you? What?
I was like, whoa.
The warm?
Yeah, it got me up. Yeah.
Yeah, so I set mine so that it warms the bed up to get me to wake up or to naturally wake up. and I wake up like refreshed rather than being like jolted awake by alarm.
Yeah, I doubled that with also that alarm clock that like is like the rising sun at the same time. Same it was here. Like the combo of both.
I still don't have that. I gotta get that.
Oh, yeah. But I mean, rarely do I combine them at the same time, but when it was really effective.
The other thing is don't have kids. That's the other thing that'll help you out.
Oh, yeah, there you go. Good advice.